Hi, thanks for your interest in the Learning Design, Innovation, and Technology program. I'm happy to introduce my faculty co-director, Jal Mehta. And Jal, as I think you know, one of the things I've really enjoyed getting to know you is your terrific books, including one on the history of education reform, and the most recent one on deeper learning, comparing and contrasting different kinds of schools around the country. I thought both were really important contributions to our understanding of learning.
Thanks, Joe. And then my co-director is Joe Blatt, who has both done a lot of work with Sesame Street, runs a very successful program in our master's program right now, and is a polymath and has read about everything. So I'm very glad that he has found a little bit of space in his reading brain for some things that I've read. So one staple of our program is the core course that we're going to co-teach together. This will be a chance for everybody in LDIT to learn together. The topic of the course is learning design, and we're going to think about learning design across a variety of different settings, in a school, in a museum, in an after-school program, on TV, and so forth. And we're going to think about, like, how do you construct a really effective learning experience across these various mediums?
And, you know, I think one of the things exciting about the program is that design is a hot topic across a whole lot of fields within the education sector and actually beyond as well. And the program's going to really try hard to deliver both a lot of concepts that will enable students to do design, to create new kinds of learning experiences at all levels. But also, we have a goal to develop dispositions and competencies so that it's both a know how to do and a know what kind of personal presence to bring to the design process. Things like working in teams, thinking outside the box, trying to bring different particular other disciplines to bear and so on. And that's reflected in the key requirements of the program, which ask students to look across a variety of different kinds of design, as well as other topics in the education sector. And we give a fair amount of freedom for electives as well, so students can build on the core of the program and add gaining expertise in areas of particular interest to them, be it a certain kind of audience you want to serve or a certain kind of learning you want to help develop.
Leaving from this program, you might become an instructional designer, coach, digital learning designer, user experience designer. You might work in professional development. You might work in human relations. As Joe says, I think kind of how to craft learning experiences for people is just a really critical skill going into the 21st century or into the next quarter of the 21st century. And that's what we're trying to prepare you.
Yeah, Joe, I love what you said about your and my work in the classroom, but also outside. I think it's important to me, and I know it is to you, that we're really passionate practitioners of design ourselves in as many ways as we can get our hands on it. And of course, the program is not just us. We're here to represent it as the faculty co-directors, but we have a dozen or more colleagues at the Ed School who are also both thinkers and practitioners of design. I'm thinking of Tina Grotzer, for example, who knows how to bring insights from cognitive science to the practice of design, like Eric Shedd, who's a model of a teacher who thinks design in terms of curriculum. So a lot of different kinds of skills among our colleagues.
So part of what we're going to help you do is help you sort of re-envision what it means to create powerful learning experiences and think about how they can be distributed across as many settings as possible.
That's terrific, Jal. And just building very briefly on that, if you think about learning in the expansive way you just described it, it starts to, I get excited about all the ways that we can help children, young people, actually learners of any age, continue to do that after school in informal settings, whether those settings are the media that are so much part of our lives every day now, or face-to-face settings designed for informal learning, like museums or theater, let's say, or and settings that are not designed for informal learning but can become so. Like one of my favorites is shopping malls, which can be wonderfully illuminating places about sociology, about economics, about how the world works in various ways. So those are things that you and I are going to keep thinking about. That's what we're engaged in. I don't know whether you and I will be looking at each other in rectangles like this in the fall, or face-to-face in classrooms at the on the Ed School campus. But either way, I'm really looking forward to teaching with you, and really looking forward to some of the people who are listening join us for as students in the new Learning Design, Innovation, and Technology program. So thanks, everyone, for watching. Thank you, John.